go.
Marhaba.
Hello.
This is Miesa Rationi, an activist organizer for the High Committee for the Defense of Palestinian Prisoners. And we are speaking now after a time when there has been a success, a rare success, for the work of the Defense of Palestinian Prisoners. What is the current context of the struggle on behalf of the liberty for the Palestinian prisoners, both inside and outside of the prisons?
Yeah, first welcome at my house and welcome in Palestine, your second home here in Palestine. I want to say something very important that all the world, I think that all the world had seen what happened in Palestine last month and before last month in September and October, what happened for the prisoners, because they began open hunger strike in the date of 27th September 2011. Why the prisoners began their open hunger strike? Because they want to tell the administrative prisons that they are want to be to live as war prisoners, to stop the isolation decision for all the prisoners, because we have 12 prisoners from all factions isolated for more than 10 years, 15 years, and for the BFLB, they began their open hunger strike on 27th, as I mentioned before, because their General Secretary Ahmed Saadat and their comrade Ahed Abu Ghulmi, every 6 months the Zionist court gave them 1 year and another year in isolated cells. So they began their open hunger strike, but before they began it in July. July in limited steps. Then they made the open hunger strike. What happened inside the prisons? All the prisoners be together in this open hunger strike from other functions, not in open hunger strike, maybe some of them in limited hunger strike. But when you say 23 days open hunger strike, just to take water and salt, nothing, just water and salt for 23 days. It is very dangerous for the health of the prisoners. It is very important in the struggle, in the Palestinian struggle inside the prisons, especially before that, because after Oslo, we didn't have this struggle inside the prisons. And it is a very strong step from the prisoners. They continue their struggle, they continue their resistance, and when they stop it, how? Because the Israeli administration inside the prisons agreed to make a negotiation between a committee from BFLB, Wael Al-Jaghoub, Ahed Abu Ghulmi, Hassan and Kamil Abu Hnesh, Hassan Taqatqa and Kamil Abu Hnesh, they are four leaders of BFLB and the Israeli inside the prisons. It is the first time that they agreed to make negotiation, direct negotiation between this committee and them to stop this open hunger strike. Why they want to stop this open hunger strike? You know why? Because the prisoners success. Really, they succeed in their open hunger strike. Even there were a deal of released 1,027 prisoners. They continue in their open hunger strike, and a lot of members of BFLB, they released while they were in open hunger strike. They returned back to Palestine, to West Bank, to Excel, to Gaza while they were in open hunger strike. They stopped their open hunger strike on Tuesday, the day of the release of the prisoners, when their leader, the leader of BFLB and the national leader, Ahmed Saadat, stopped his open hunger strike. And why, I will return back, why the Israeli administration agreed. You know why? Because it is very dangerous for them inside the prison to maybe one of the prisoners maybe will die, some of them will be illness, and the media outside, all the media outside with the prisoners, and it is very important issue when you make hunger strike. And if it is spread all the prison and all the prisons,
that's what I wanted to ask you.
Yeah,
because I understand, we heard that on the day that there were 1,000 prisoners ready to join the hunger strike on a limited basis.
Yeah.
They were ready to join the hunger strike of the 200 who were on an unlimited hunger strike. That very day was the announcement for the release
of
the Israeli soldier, with the concomitant release of the 1,027 Palestinian prisoners.
They thought that it will be stopped. They thought, the Zionists thought that the open hunger strike will stopped immediately when the agreement of release the prisoners began. But no, never. They continued, the prisoners, the BFLB continued their resistance inside the prisons, all the prisons, and they continued their open hunger strike. And as I told you, they released while they were in an open hunger strike. But what is the dangerous inside the prisons? You know, we have a lot of prisons in our area, 1948, in south of Palestine, and north of Palestine. At the beginning, it was just in Nafha, Asqalan, Ramon, Bir Saba. Those prisons, they are in the south Palestine, and the open hunger strike started from those prisons. But after, it began in Hadarim, in the north, Idamun, and with the female women, they began open hunger strike in Idamun, in Jalbou, in Shatta, in Majiddo, in Afar, which is a camp for a military camp, not a prison. But all of the prisoners there began their open hunger strike. So, and the second, the very important point, that others from leaders, others leaders from other functions, like Hamas, we have five leaders from Hamas, Abdullah al-Barghouti, Abbas al-Sayyid, Hassan Salami, Jamal Abu al-Heja, whom with Mr. Ahmed Saadat in the same isolated cell, they began open hunger strike with the BFLB. And some from the Democratic, Wajdi Jude, some from the Communist, Basim al-Khundaqji and Ibrahim Nassasri, others from Fatah, like Abu Naji, who released, and 10 youth from inside the Afar prison, Shukri Aish from Al-Naqab, a lot of Fatah.
So this was a really unified national struggle of the
and
prisoners.
It is the very, what can I say, for the Zionists, for the Israeli, it is not good that all the prisoners will begin this open hunger strike. At the first, they began with the BFLB, 304 person from BFLB began their open hunger strike, all the prisons. But when the others joined them at the beginning, unlimited hunger strike. What is the unlimited hunger strike? To return back the meal which the prisons director gave us in the prison. So it is very important that it is expensive for the director of prisons. It cost them a lot of money to return this meal back and not to take this. And it is a step of struggle inside the prisons. And then when all of them began to join the others, it is very dangerous inside the prisons. So
it also means that the prisoners are gaining their freedom.
Yeah.
Because they are no longer controlled 100% by the prison authorities and by the state
authorities. Yeah, we are talking about 7,300 prisoners, female, young, and men.
How many prisoners are there in total?
And now, after the release of 1,027 prisoners, we have 6,500 prisoners inside the prisons. From them, we have 320 children. We have 10 ladies inside the prison. They didn't release in this agreement. So it is very important. And as I told you before, it is very dangerous when the prisoners began a struggle inside the prisons.
A unified struggle.
Yeah, a unified struggle.
Because this can inspire.
And, I want to tell you that we have in prisons, we have 103 militaries were in this hunger strike. Not this hunger strike before. In the struggle of hunger strike, in the struggle of not to allow the director of the prisons to do what they want, we have 103 prisoners died through these struggles.
Who have died?
Yeah, yeah, they were killed. Not died, killed because of open hunger strike, killed by shooting, some of them, Al-Ashqar shooting in the Nakab, killed by disease. And a lot of prisoners were died because of they continue in open hunger strike before in 17th, 16th, and 18th. So the Israeli director or administration in the prisons know that if the prisoners, the Palestinian prisoners, began and continue more than 10 days, more than 10 days, so they will continue. It is dangerous for them that the prisoners will continue their strike. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is very important, and they want to stop them. So they agree to sit with this committee. And I want to talk about what the protocol they signed. They signed to the Palestinian committee and the Zionist administration inside the prison in Bir Sabah, Ishel. They signed a protocol. That after stopping the open hunger strike, they will return back all the prisoners from isolated cells to be in the same prison in the same part.
Oh, yes.
To make them together.
What is the state of Ahmed Sadat now?
But what happened? I want to tell you something else, and to deal with them in another bonds, because the open hunger strike not just for isolated to stop the isolation decision, to let our families visit their children or their sons or their daughter, to let the brother see his sister, to let the husband see his wife inside the prison, to let them to see their children. You know that we have father, mother, and child in the same prison, and they didn't see each other in the same prison. And this is one of our struggle. The third, that to let the lawyer to visit the prisoners inside the prison, to let the Red Cross to see them, to make something inside the prisons good for them, not just eating or something, because they stopped your money, your income money from outside. They close it. So how the prisoners will continue their living?
What about education?
The education. It is very important. Bon, thank you for mentioning this, because it is a war between us and the Zionists inside the prisons. Because for this year, for 5 years, they didn't allow the children, especially the children, to continue their secondary school inside the prison before they let us to continue our studying, but they stopped it. This is the fifth year, and before 6 months, Benjamin Netanyahu, with the law of Shalit, he took a decision to stop the prisoners to continue their studying in the universities. they let them to continue this semester, mm-hmm. and after they stop it, it is a very important a case. But why? Because our weapon, not just as Palestinian, the people outside thought that our weapon is just gun or shooting or killing the Israeli. No, no. Our main weapon is our studying, our education.
And are they going to be allowed to continue their studies
what
now?
What happened inside the prison, they didn't want the children to have good mind. They want to delete everything from their mind. It is very important point for the children.
So now, what is the concessions on education?
About the protocol, when they signed it, they agree to return back for the education. But what happened? What happened? We stopped, the prisoners stopped their open hunger strike. What happened? We don't trust of any agreement with the Zionists. Really, really, we don't trust. So our struggle will continue. Our resistance will continue. How? Immediately after 2 days from stopping the open hunger strike, they gave Ahmed Saada, the general secretary of BFLB, another 1 year in isolated cell. As they wrote in the Zionist media, they wrote that the decision was before the open hunger strike, but they didn't told Mr. Ahmed Saadat about this decision. And they took the decision without Ahmed Saadat in the court, and they didn't allow the Damir committee to be inside the court, and it is illegal. So they will continue and isolated the prisoners. But what happened? They returned back the other prisoners whom were in open hunger strike to the prisons. They released them from isolated cells, and they returned back. But until now, we have two from BFLB in isolated cells. The General Secretary Ahmed Saadat, Ahed Abu Ghulmi, Abbas Al-Sayed, four from Hamas, Abbas Al-Sayed, Abdullah Al-Barghouthi, Jamal Abu Al-Hijja, and Hassan Salami, six. So they didn't, until now, agree that those six persons will return back to live with the other prisoners.
In general population?
Yeah.
Now, when is the next group of prisoners to be released?
I want to say something about the agreement of the release of the prisoners. All of us as Palestinians, whom will release our prisoners is very good, really. Fatah, Hamas, BFLB, Democratic, any function, it is happy for us, and it is our pleasure that any prisoner will be released from prison. What about even the resistance release our prisoners? It is very good. The resistance, the resistance in Gaza, whom have Shalit, they release our prisoners. They release 1,027 prisoners. It is very happy for all of us, really. What is the important of this agreement? You know what is? Not that they release that prisoner or that prisoner. No, they had broken the Israeli decision. How? The Israeli decision inside the prisons not to release the five women who sentenced for all their lives. Sana Ishhade, Ahlam Al-Tamimi, Qahira Al-Saadi, Daa Al-Jayusi, Amni Muna. All the time, any negotiation, the Zionists forbidden, they put X. Not to talk about those five girls. The resistance released them. It is very good. The second, they released, the resistance released, the people, our people, not whom have the Israeli identity with two quotations, they released the prisoners from Jerusalem, from our area 1948, from Jolan, the highest of Jolan. It is the first time after 1985. And 1983 with Ahmed Jibril, BFLB, Ahmed Jibril, who released a lot of more than 1,000 with the Zionists in Lebanon. And after Hezbollah in Lebanon, who released the Samir Kantar, Khodir, and others, the Lebanese. It is very good. And this is the first time, the second time that the Palestinian resistance, they had broken this decision. Really, we are happy. Really, we are happy. They broken it.
And there are another 550 prisoners that are due to be released soon.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know when they will be released?
But before, I want to say something. It is for us, we feel sad. Why? Because a lot of prisoners who released, they were in exile.
In exile.
Exile. Yeah, it is very sad for us to be in Syria, Qatar, Turkish, and in our land, Gaza. And this is our land, Gaza, but it is exile, really. They separated the prisoners from their families, the wife, the kids, and it is very hard for us. But even it is a success for the resistance. Even it is a success for the resistance in Gaza, whom they were had shalit to release this number of prisoners. But for me, I think that I hope that they release all the prisoners. If you ask my opinion, I am happy.
Do you think that...
I hope that they released all the prisoners whom before Oslo. Because we have some of them until now in prison.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I hope that all of them released. But how they will be released, I don't know. I will answer you about your question about 550 prisoners who will be released. They will be released after Al-Adha feast. Yeah, maybe in November or at least in December, before the new year, they will be released. But what happened for the home?
Who are remaining? Is there much hope for the President Mahmoud Abbas? He wants to negotiate the release of another 1,000 prisoners.
Yeah, before
is there
this,
much hope that
yeah,
success
before this,
in
but
that
I want to tell you something about the 550 prisoners who will be released. We asked the resistance in Gaza to join or to the 10th girls whom are at prison. It was a very big fault. Especially that we have three of them had with two quotation the Israeli identity whom are from our area 1948. Yeah, we hope that the 10th girls will be released with the 550 prisoners, and we are afraid from this continue of the agreement because whom will put the names, who will be the negotiation, the Egyptians and the Israeli just without the resistance, without the Palestinian. So we hope that as the points which the resistance mentioned that whom more than 10 years, not under 10 years, we hope this will be happen, but we are afraid of this step.
Yes.
About Mahmoud Abbas, what happened with Mahmoud Abbas, when the agreement is finished and the day after the release of the prisoners, the president, Mahmoud Abbas, in his speech told us by the media that there will be agreement for him and there will be another release for the prisoners for Abbas. We hope it will be recently, maybe. We hope really. And as I told you before, any person, any function, release any prisoners, we are happy. We are happy.
Do you think that it's likely that he will succeed, or?
But what I want to say, it is very important that our president now, Abbas, he is under pressure. You know that Palestinian government went to the United Nations to take our membership in the United Nations General Assembly. Yeah?
Yes.
But what happened until now, every week they delayed it. They delayed to take the decision. Why? They delayed to take the decision. And every week they asked Abbas to return back to the negotiation between the Israeli and Abbas. I think and I afraid of something will happen. If they will release prisoners for Abbas, they will make pressure upon him to stop our steps in the United Nations with our membership in the United Nations General Assembly or the Security Council. But I trust our PLO leaders to continue their steps to fight, because it is our war.
And you would encourage them to continue
them to continue their war, because it is our war inside the United Nations to have our membership. But what happened, I think that they make now pressure upon him to return back to the direction negotiation between the leadership of Palestinian Authority and the Zionist under the USA umbrella, not under the United Nations umbrella. And this is very dangerous for us, because all the people agree with our leader Abbas to go to the United Nations. And we agree in his speech. It was a very important speech. When he was talking in his speech in the United Nations, he talks in a strong speech.
He even mentioned the right of return for the refugees.
The refugees and the prisoners. So we encourage Abbas to continue this step, not to agree even they want to release the prisoners. For me, as a Palestinian, not to agree under any pressure. Mm-hmm. No, I ask him to continue our war inside United Nations and not to agree to return back to the direction negotiation, because it is not our umbrella. The United Nations is the mother of the Zionists. So I asked him not to agree about this, really. And all the people here, even they want to release some leaders, maybe some prisoners, we hope that all of the prisoners, but not to be under this pressure. And we trust on our leaders, Palestinian Liberation Organization decision. And he have to return back to the Palestinian Liberation Organization. He have to return back, not to take the decision by himself, really.
Very good. Miaser Ationi, we thank you very much, you know, for your testimony. That explains, you know, to a general audience, an English audience in particular, you know, what is really happening in Palestine. And it's very necessary for this explanation to be heard by as many people as possible. We thank you again very, very, very much.
Thank you. Welcome.
Thank you. But I'd like to ask you, just, you know, let's continue the film, you know, to add on something. You know, we were just hearing, you know, some bells from a church.
Yeah.
Isn't that interesting? We hear bells from a church in Palestine. We also hear the mosque, you know, like prayers.
Yeah, you have.
So we hear both, you know?
No.
So this is a very pluralistic society.
You are in Nablus.
Yes.
You know Nablus?
Yes.
Nablus, we have here, this is my area. Look, this house for Christian.
Yes.
This house for Christian.
Yes.
This house for Muslims.
Yes.
This house for Muslims. That house for Christian. That house for Christian.
Yes.
Yeah.
So everyone's
so
mixed.
So my area here in Rafidia.
Yes.
We are not deal as Muslims and Christians. We are the same families. In their feasts, we go to visit them. In our feast, in this feast, they will come to visit us. Even as, I don't know if you saw them, in the tent, in the open hunger strike, they came, the guests and all of them, they came to the open hunger strike and joined us with our hunger strike. And they made one day, Friday, open hunger strike for all of them.
Oh,
for all of them in Palestine, not just in Rafidia and Nablus. And you know that here in Nablus we have three religions, a Christian, Muslims, and Samarit.
Oh, Samarit, who are the ancient Jewish.
Yeah, the ancient Jewish.
Yes, the pre-Talmudic and, Jewish community the Samarit, that remained in Palestine.
We have a comrade, Nader Sadaqa, who sentenced BFLB from Samarit, and he is now in Bir Sabah. He was in open hunger strike. He was sentenced for six for all his life.
Wow.
And they want to put him in with the prisoners 1948 in Jerusalem. He forbidden this and made inside the prison a strike and began to resist. And now he is with his comrade in Bir Sabah. And he was in open hunger strike. He is here in Tour Mountain. So here in Palestine, I want to tell you that in Palestine, we are in good relation, the two religious. And here we are Palestinian. We are people.
Yes.
We love to live in good life. We love to be in love. We love to be in sports, to dance, to sing, to fight, to resist, to let our children blaze. Yeah, we love the life. Not to just as the others know or the Zionist media to mention all that, just we want to kill the Zionist, to quotation the Israeli, no. The Jewish come to live with us here, as religious, not as Zionist. Come to live with us. If he is a Jewish and he like Naturi Karta in Jerusalem, they are Jewish, religious, and they live with us in Jerusalem. It's okay for us. And you know that Palestine is a holy land for the three religious.
Yeah. Tell us, this structure here, these old stones, this old wall here, that is broken, and but how old is this, and what does this represent? What does it come from?
Look, our houses, old houses here, this old house, and this is old house, and that. Under, we have another old houses. It is ancient houses. My house, maybe you can take photo for our house.
I saw the double arches in the roof.
Yeah, the ceiling, the high ceiling.
Like a dome.
Yeah, like a dome. Like the dome of the rock, really.
Yes.
Yeah, and the churches.
Yes.
Yeah, here, the churches, high
ceiling.
They
also have a dome as
well. Yeah, high ceiling and the dome, the mosques and the churches. It was more than my house, more than 500 years. Yeah. Nablus is very ancient city, the first ancient city, Jericho, all the world, Jericho, then Nablus.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, we have